Bottom of the seventh inning in Toronto, Russell Martin, who was charged with the error which led to the go-ahead run. Martin leads off against Hamels, with the Rangers leading 3-2.
Jeff Bannister will start this inning with his bullpen getting warm after that lengthy delay for his starting pitcher, Cole Hamels.
The delay was 18 minutes after Martin's throw back to the mound hit the bat of Chu. There's Stubbs in center, replacing the Shields. Broken bat for Robert. Andrews could not handle it. Leadoff bat on for the Blue Jays in the bottom of the seventh.
That's the speed of Russell Martin. Not a lot of catchers run very well. Forces Andrews to hustle, have to hustle. He just misplayed it. He doesn't miss many balls.
Yeah, he just clanked it. He had time. You see, he closed the glove early off the heel. Postseason elimination game. Tension builds.
So an error committed by Andrews. Here's Pillar, who has struck out twice today. Good foul down the left field line.
It's a big error with Andrews right there, because it does. You had Cole Hamels in a nice little roll. He came right back after the delay. And that you get that quick out early. It keeps the crowd out of it, everything. That was a big error.
Nothing at two on Pillar.
Well, and they're going for the juggler right now. You got Justin Smoke out on the on-deck circle, hit for Goins. So they're going to make a move. I thought maybe you might see Pillar moving a little bit, but that's not going to be the case. Moving meaning move the runner, not the case here. Good rips. I tell you, there's a lot of guys that have really played well, and their stock has gone through the roof. Nobody more than this guy. He's been so impressive.
Yeah, I agree, and that's why from the get-go, that's why he swings the bat. Toronto doesn't really play to manufacture runs, but he's been one of their hotter sticks in the lineup.
We've watched him have some power. He's shown the speed, the great defense, throw. He's done it all in the four and almost five games now in this series.
The 106th pitch from Cole Hamels.
Well, I think Cole Hamels gets through this as much as he can this inning, and then that's all we're going to see from him. This is going to be a bullpen game the rest of the way out.
Well, he's got Pillar in swing mode right now. He's been pounding that cutter in. I'm very surprised Hamels shows him anything in the zone.
The left-hander Jake Diekman and the right-hander Sam Dyson in the Texas pen. Ground to the right side. Everybody's safe.
Oh my. You got the left-handed first baseman. He's got the easy throw for the force. And Moreland just yanked it.
Once again, tension, late innings, postseason elimination game, nothing routine.
Well, what happens here? It allows them to bring Goins back out here to bunt. Andrews almost came up with it. But now you take Justin Smoke back. Look at Russell Martin take the lane out right there. And that takes away a little bit of the angle to throw. And that causes a little bit of a shank. But I think he had already gripped the ball poorly before Russell Martin made his turn.
Two errors in the inning. First Andrews and then Moreland.
And the point is, they've taken Justin Smoke back, and now you manufacture. You bring Goins, at least Goins in the game, to drop the bunt.
Set up nicely for Toronto, as you said. Goins for a bunt, and Revere, their best contact hitter, behind him.
It'd be interesting to see how they try to use a bullpen, because they got Beckman up. You want him to pitch to Revere if you get to that point. And you have Dyson as well, but then you go to all the right-handed hitters.
Goins, 0 for 15 of the series, but he's made some tremendous defensive plays. Two on, nobody out.
The seventh inning, you'll never forget.
Wants Beltre to field this bunt.
And that's all just to see if Goins is squaring around.
Foul, nothing and one.
And you're right, Tom. The execution here is to push that ball to third base.
Well, Texas did put the wheel play on. Beltre charges hard. Andrews covers third.
Yeah, but
I could also run a fake wheel play here to try to get the pickoff at second base. Now we'll get a runner from Martin.
Dalton Pompey, the local native.
A lot of teams, once they show that wheel play with the shortstop vacating, they'll have the shortstop break early and move the second baseman in behind on a timed pickoff play. Pompey has to be careful not to leave too soon cheap.
Even if they have a wheel play on, if you're Goins and you're the bunter, all you got to do is deaden that ball in front of home plate and still bunt it to third base and make them field it. After back-to-back errors, I'd be surprised if they take a gamble to throw and try to get the lead run.
So Pompey takes his lead off second. Pilar off first. 0-1 to Goins. Bumped it. Beltre goes to third. Bases loaded.
He dropped it. He took great execution. Look at Beltre, the spin, perfect throw. And Elvis just, Andrews just dropped it. He just dropped it.
Three outs. Texas had all three outs in this inning in hand. They sit here with none, and the bases loaded.
Protecting the catcher, you're going to see the play. Jimenez comes up, he's got a force. But I think Pompey's in the right. You got to take him out. He's still on the plate. He's engaged to the plate. You got to take him out. I thought it was a clean play.
He wants the umpire, as Jeff Bannister does, to take a look at this play.
It's a clean slide. If this was at second base, you want to be within being able to touch the base. He's within being able to touch the plate. And now the catcher becomes another infielder for me. It's a double play ball, I'm sorry.
That's the dichotomy between how the middle infield and the plate are treated. Catcher has protection where he cannot be targeted. middle infielders do not, as long as that runner is within arm's length of the base.
Can you imagine if they call a double play here? Woo!
A wild seventh inning. Go-ahead run scores in the top half on a play that most people here at Rogers Center have never seen before. And now in the bottom half of the inning, three errors committed by the Texas Rangers.
You know, again, we got two former catchers managing. And looking at Gibbons' reaction in the dugout, I think he was kind of like, we may not get this call our direction.
One more look from above.
He's got to take him out. I think they're going to, this call's going to stay where it's at. And so are we, and I know you are at home.
When we come back, bases loaded, one out, Donaldson to the plate.
Is struck by the catcher's throw back to the pitcher, and in the umpire's judgment, there is no intent on the part of the batter to interfere with the throw, then the ball is alive and in play. Now, people wondering, why was there a review there? There's an explanation for that as well. The umpires on the field called for a crew chief review of a rules check that was prior to the protest from John Gibbons.
All right, thanks very much, Ken. Bases loaded, one out. Sam Dyson on to face Josh Donaldson. The right-hander out of the Rangers' pen.
And all the Rangers are doing right here, trying to look to get a double play ball.
That's going to be difficult for the middle infielders because Revere has a tremendous lead at first and will be on top of the middle infielders very quickly, trying to turn two.
To look for if you're Josh Donaldson. They're sitting 2-0. It's the clincher. Texas has had a bad inning, and they got to come to you right now.
Three errors in the inning committed by the Rangers. And now time is called by the home plate umpire, Dale Scott.
Dale Scott's had a tough inning, but he's got the calls right. He really has. The slide right there and the ball off the bat.
The 2-0, a blue. Over the glove, over the door. Pilar scores. And the Rangers get the out at second.
Boy, they got the force at second, but that shows you how strong Donaldson is, but I don't know why Odor didn't turn and run and get it. That's all those balls that fooled you.
Exactly right. It fooled him. And Revere turns his back on the baseball, so he's not able to get to second base. Here's the ball directly over his head, backpedaling, but just beyond him, and recovers in time for the force at second base.
But on Revere's point, he's got a huge lead where he's at right there. If Odor catches it, he's thinking I'm double up. That's why he's going back, because that's a ball you think he's going to catch.
What next?
Are we tied? Oh my goodness. Oh, what a game, huh?
What an inning. The seventh inning to this point has taken 40 minutes. Runners on the corners, two outs.
If you look at the Rangers, they've had five outs in this inning already. Got the one at the plate, got the one at second. They've had six, basically. They kicked three.
And the scoreboard only says two.
Donaldson driving in the tying run on a fielder's choice. After the Rangers took the lead in bizarre fashion in the top half.
So long, and it's gonna burn you.
Admiring the blast.
Admired the blast the whole time. But also, this has just been a crazy half inning. The emotions are at the all-time high. But as I was watching this, the first thing, look, everybody's calling for Bautista to come out for a curtain call. So if you're Dyson, that's what you're seeing. Bautista is trying to tell the fans, quit throwing things on the field.
Encarnacion.
Encarnacion, I mean.
As we saw from other Blue Jays earlier, he's trying to get the crowd to calm down.
Quit throwing stuff. That's what he's doing. Calm down. Because the game has already been delayed. That's why you kept seeing some of the replays.
And there's Dyson. He took exception. He did not realize what Encarnacion was doing as far as calming down the crowd.
Yeah, it looks to him like he's saying, yes, more and more. And that's not what he's doing. Look, what you did not see is there are people running on the field in the outfield. There's beer cans chucked everywhere. They've got bottles. I mean, they've got baskets of garbage in the right field corner that the grounds crew's picking up. This is the scene that's going on that Encarnacion was telling people, calm down.
Can't recall another baseball game where emotions ran so high, both sides and in the stands.
Remember, the dugouts and bullpens had emptied in game two of this series here in Toronto.
Well, I know Bautista hit a bomb, and it's a big one. But if I'm on the other side, that's got to hurt.
Absolutely.
It just does.
And especially the way this inning unfolded. You could see the tension in the way the Rangers kept mishandling the baseball.
But what a seventh inning. One you will never forget. You'll be talking about where you were when it happened.
Top of the seventh, the Rangers took a 3-2 lead.
And the Rangers are asking for somebody to be thrown out of the stands. And that's the exception that you're seeing.
Let's head down to the field. Check in again with Ken Rosenthal. Ken.
Guys, right before that melee started, or near melee, the Rangers were gesturing toward that very area. Jeff Banister, very animated. A fan must have done something. They want a fan from that area ejected, if not more than one fan.
We've seen more police presence now around the perimeter field, moving into the bullpen of the Texas Rangers. And there's Jeff Banister pointing out someone he wants identified to security officials.
So hopefully security will take care of it. There's the Texas bullpen.
Well, they've had to bring security back on the field.
There's the drive by Bautista. Three-run shot. Second home run of the last two innings by the Blue Jays.
What in a crazy, crazy half. Bautista's starting to heat up. He's missed some balls on the inside. He got the base hit earlier.
Russell Martin right here. Yes.
Russell Martin, who committed the error, the throw which hit off the bat of Chu. Martin was pitch run for earlier in this inning.
I really think they should just take the players off the field for a minute and calm this place down. It's been out of control. And the only way you get that control back is you call a timeout and they make an announcement. It's not a safe environment to have players on the field right now. Not when people are chucking beer cans from the third deck. Now let's go back to baseball real quick. It starts with this error right here.
That's one out.
Then here's the second out. The bad throw by Moreland. The short hop to Andrus can't handle it. And then they get the bunt play. The right bunt play on. Get the throw. Clanks it. And now you sit bases loaded with no outs.
Three routine plays.
There's Cole Hamels, the Rangers starter. Encarnacion homered way back in the sixth inning. Way back. About an hour ago.
Man alive.
That tied the game at two. And then a seventh inning that we will never forget.
Well, you got Encarnacion hit a home run. You got Donaldson with a bloop. And you got Bautista with a three-run homer. When that happens for the Jays, that's hard to beat.
The three Jays who combined for 120 home runs. And well over 300 runs batted in during the regular season. Jeff Banister's Rangers won the first two games of this series here in Toronto. Blue Jays won the last two games when facing elimination, something that Toronto had never done in the history of the franchise. Encarnacion on at first. The inning continues.
Well, other than Bautista's home run, death by a thousand paper cuts. This offense here in the seventh inning.
Seventh. Base hit right field. Encarnacion to second.
What an inning that the Blue Jays had to come back from. Think about the emotional roller coaster they were on.
Well, I think too about the emotional roller coaster of Dyson. You know, brought into this game as a sinker ball pitcher. We talked about defending the home run of the Blue Jays. It was the right choice. A guy who had not allowed a home run as a Ranger to a right-handed batter. Well, Bautista changed that history and the emotional roller coaster. Well, it's hit the bottom right now for Dyson.
But he's got one more out to get. Gotta get it. I tell you what, the Blue Jays, though, to fight back the way they did, the emotional roller coaster that Russell Martin went through, you throw a ball back, you'll never see that in a million throws back to the pitcher. Hits the bat and ricochets off. And the play was called correctly. And for them to come back and be able to put these points on the board and take the lead in this crazy half inning, this crazy inning, I should say, it's amazing.
Sam Dyson, a former Blue Jay, pitched the two games for Toronto back in 2012. Got a two with his former teammate Encarnacion earlier, following the Bautista home run.
Funny thing is, he and Marcus Stroman played double-A ball together, and he actually taught Stroman his sinker.
Wow. To Lewinsky, 0 for 3. Two on, two out.
This inning has been, they were one pitch away from getting out of it even after three errors. So you've got to give the Blue Jays some credit. You make that many mistakes and an opportunity for an offense to get going like this, you're going to get burned. But somebody had to deliver. They came up with some big hits to do it.
Has gone through in this inning have boiled over. The frustration apparent in the exchange between Dyson and Tulowitzki is what
here's what happened. Dyson just gave him a little tap, said, "Hey man, it's over." He's like, "Why are you touching me?" And the next thing you know, it goes to another level. So here it is, Dyson, the inning's over. Tulo's like, "Hey man, we're fighting against each other. I'm not your pal right now."
What an inning. What a game. What a series.
Tell you what, the Rangers didn't die though. Every at bat this half inning. Odor's at bat was a good at bat. Napoli just missed the double down the line. So did Odor down the right field line. Venables battled 3-2, getting good swings. It made it work.
Eighth pitch of the at bat to Venable. Jose Bautista with a three-run home run in the bottom of the seventh inning to send the Blue Jays to their first ALCS since 1993. A wild game. It took 3 hours, 37 minutes, including a 43-minute inning and then a 53-minute seventh inning that will go down in baseball history.
I've always seen postseason games with beanball wars. I've seen postseason games with a fight in the bullpen in Fenway Park. I've seen a brawl between the Yankees and the Red Sox, but I've never seen the kind of raw emotion of the game like we saw today.
As the Blue Jays celebrate, down for the field, Ken.
Jose.
Tremendo.
Joe Carter once hit a really big home run here. You know all about it. I'm sure you've dreamed of hitting a home run like that. What was that feeling like at that moment?
Obviously, that home run was different as a walk-off, and it was in the World Series. And I can only hope that I get that same opportunity. But right now, we moved on. That was obviously a good result to that at bat. I was looking for something up. I know he throws hard and a lot of sinkers. I swung the first one down. I just said, see it up, and I put a great swing on it, and it felt great. I'm still enjoying it.
On the scale of all the games you've ever played, where did this one rank in intensity?
Intensity and emotion. It's the most emotionally charged game that I've ever played. So many mood swings. We took the lead and we lost it, and all the stuff that was going on. Bottom line is, we came out on top and we got to enjoy the victory and move on.
Now, you had an epic bat flip. Was that the emotion of the moment of what had happened in the top half just taking over?
It's just the whole game. You know, it's a big game. It's a do or die game on a tight series. Winner, you know, obviously advances. I don't mean any disrespect whenever I do anything like that, and I certainly didn't plan it. It was just the moment. I felt it, and I did it, and I'm just glad I was able to help out the team in that moment.
Jose, thank you very much. Thanks. Kenny, back to you.
Thanks very much, Ken. Jose Bautista, who once played for four teams in a season, is the hero. And then Osuna closes things out for the Jays.
So just an incredible game. The intensity and the controversy. You're never going to see another game like this.
This was a team that completely remade itself late in the year to be playoff caliber with trades. But today, you saw some homegrown players rise in the big moments. Ryan Goins with great plays at second base and treating the end of the game to Aaron Sanchez and Roberto Osuna. Youngsters who grew up a lot in Game 5.
The Blue Jays continue to celebrate.